Hi, Chef Joe Crockett with Healthy Kids Inc. Today we're going to be making a vegetable lasagna. Now this is a dish that the kids are going to love. So we're going to start first. I've got a pan with a little bit of olive oil heating over medium-high heat. It's come up to temp. So we're going to start. We've got some chopped onion. We have a little bit of chopped bell pepper that you could roast beforehand or buy the roasted variety if you wanted to. We're just going to throw ours in and saute it with the rest. We've got some zucchini and some mushrooms that we're going to saute as well. So we're going to start with our onions. You could also throw in a little bit of garlic too if you wanted. You could use red onion in this too, so feel free to deviate and mix it up. Start with our onions. Season these a little bit with salt. A little fresh cracked black pepper. Go in with our bell pepper. Do this until these just start to become soft, and we'll add in the rest. Our onions are now translucent and our peppers are softened. I'm going to go in with our zucchini. It doesn't take as long to cook. We're going to saute this for just a couple more minutes. We're going to pull all of this out and then add it to our medium-sized mixing bowl. We're going to then add our mushrooms in and saute those lightly. And then combine everything into that mixing bowl. And then we'll begin to layer our lasagna in a baking dish. Now, the recipe calls for the no-boil lasagna noodles. But if you don't have those, all you have to do is parboil them. And that just means to throw them in the boiling water for about 3/4 of the time that you normally would. You want them to still have a little bit of a bite to them, so that way that when you cook them the rest of the way in the oven, that they'll turn out the correct doneness when you're done. So, I'm going to add a little bit more seasoning to this. Not much salt because we don't want to pull too much moisture out of our zucchini. A little bit more pepper. Just long enough to soften our zucchini up. If you like spices, you could also add in a little bit of chili flake to this. You could even add a splash of balsamic vinegar to your veggies as they saute. If you were making this just for the adults in the family, you could even add in a little bit of red wine. Okay, so our zucchini is now nice and soft. We're going to transfer this to our bowl. It's okay if you have a little bit left in your pan. I'm just going to add just a touch of oil because we already have a little bit left in the pan. We're going to add our mushrooms. Allow those to begin to start sauteing. You want to season these as well. Like we've said before, you always want to season in layers. A little bit of salt. A little bit of fresh cracked black pepper. Quick saute. Mushrooms add a nice earthy note to any dish. They're a perfect meat substitute if you're ever trying to go meatless. They have that nice meaty texture. Can kind of give you the illusion of meat without actually having meat in a dish. For just a minute. In the meantime, we have our oven preheating to 375 degrees. Okay, so once your mushrooms just get just a touch of color onto them, you'll see that they've kind of got a nice sheen to them. You can add those to the rest of your vegetables. kill the heat on the stove and allow this to cool slightly. You could toss it in the fridge for a minute to let it cool down, and that's what I'm going to do, and then we'll begin layering. Okay, so we have chilled our mixture slightly, just enough to let it kind of cool down. Now what we're going to do is add in our herbs. Bit for later and give this a quick stir to combine. Okay, we can set this aside for a minute. Now what I've done in the bottom of my baking dish is I went ahead and put a layer of our noodles down. Now we're going to go in with a layer of our marinara. You can kind of just spoon it in. Like that. Now we can do a layer of cheese. We're also going to crack our egg. Always crack our eggs into a dish on the off chance that there would be anything wrong. Okay, so we're also going to take some ricotta cheese. And don't worry about it being in clumps, it'll kind of melt out. So you just want to place a few in there. We'll continue to repeat the process. But first we're going to combine our egg in with our vegetable mixture that we've already sautéed. Once you've had your egg in, you can kind of crack the yolk. Mix all of it together. That's just going to act a bit as a binder. And we can go in with a layer of our vegetables. Work on spreading everything out. Can work a little lighter on the bottom layer. Then we'll go in with some more noodles. Kind of shingle them. These just have just a touch of olive oil on them. Go down with some more marinara. A little heavier on this level.
Can you say that again? Because that's
yeah. Okay, so we just added another level of marinara. I went a little heavier on that level. Just some more cheese. And you can be as heavy or as light-handed as you like with your fillings and your toppings. It just really depends on personal taste. Do a little bit of parm. I didn't do any on the bottom level, but we do have some on this middle level. I like to say most of it for the top. But like I said, this is really like building your house. You can kind of build it any way you want. As long as you follow the layering principle, what you do in each layer, you could have a different filling on each level. Some people don't put sauce on every level, so it really just depends on your personal taste. Okay, so I'm going to add some of our ricotta. I last of our vegetables. We'll do our top layer. Make sure you scrape it off the sides of your bowl. Get every last bit of it. Your spatula. Kind of fan it out. Like I said before, the ricotta will kind of even out. You can spread it some with your spatula, but as the heat is applied to it in the oven, it will melt and become nice and creamy. All right, we're gonna go on top. Another layer of our noodles. Now, I've seen people make the mistake before of thinking that you can put a dry noodle into your lasagna. It will not turn out the way that you're anticipating if you do. It will cook them, but if you don't have enough moisture in the mix, they really won't cook all the way, and you'll end up with something that's quite a bit more than al dente. So try to avoid that if you can. Another layer of sauce. I'm gonna pour the rest over and we'll spread it out. Just use the back of your spoon. Now we can finish with cheese. Get parm on top. A little bit of our fresh herbs. Salt and pepper on top. Okay, so now we've got our cheese, our sauce, our fresh herbs, our fillings, nice seasoning. We're gonna add just a little bit of oil on top, and then we're gonna cook this for 40 minutes covered and 15 to 20 uncovered. Show you the finished product in just a little bit. Okay, so we've reached our 40 minute mark. We're pulling this out and removing the lid so that we can get it brown on the top. I'm gonna put it back in the oven for another 20 minutes until it comes out nice and bubbly.